Hi everyone. Today we're going to investigate the derivatives of inverse trig functions. First, let's review some inverse trig functions. For the sine function, when we restrict its domain from negative power 2 to power 2, then this part of sine function is 1 to 1 and it will have inverse. The inverse function of sine is denoted by inverse sine or arcsine. And remember, when two functions are inverse functions, their domain and range will be switched. So the domain of this restricted sine function is negative power 2 to power 2. That will become the range for the inverse sine function. So the range for inverse sine function will be from negative power 2 to power 2. And now the range for this sine function right here is negative 1 to 1, which will become the domain for the inverse sine function. So inverse sine function of x has domain to be negative 1 to 1 and range to be negative power 2 to power 2. Now let's get to the cosine function. The cosine function, when we restrict the domain from 0 to pi, then this part of cosine function is 1 to 1, so it has inverse. The inverse cosine function is denoted by inverse cosine, or in another notation, we call it arc cosine x. Because cosine and inverse cosine, they are inverse function, so domain and range will be switched. So domain for this restricted cosine over here is 0 to pi. That will become the range for this inverse cosine. The range for this cosine x over here is negative 1 to 1, and that will become the domain for this inverse cosine. So inverse cosine function has domain to be negative 1 to 1 and range to be 0 to pi, including 0 and pi. Now, what about tangent of x? Tangent of x is not 1 to 1. However, if we restrict its domain to negative power 2 to power 2, then tangent of x will be 1 to 1 on this restricted domain, and it takes on every value in this range, it will have inverse. The inverse for this restricted tangent x is inverse tangent of x. The inverse function of this restricted tangent of x is inverse tangent of x. Another notation for that is arctangent of x. These two are equivalent. The domain for this restricted tangent of x is the open interval from negative power 2 to power 2. That will become the range for this inverse tangent of x. So the inverse tangent x has range to be this open interval from negative power 2 to power 2. The range for this tangent of x over here is all real numbers. So that will become the domain for this inverse tangent of x, and that is all real numbers. Now let's investigate the derivative of inverse sine of x. So we let y to be inverse sine of x. We are looking for y prime, which is dy dx. We don't know the derivative for inverse sine. However, we do know the derivative for sine. So we're trying to rewrite this equation to relate to sine. So if y is equal to inverse sine of x, then x is equal to sine of y. Because inverse sine and sine are inverse function, so they will undo each other. So x over here will be equal to sine of y. Now to find y prime, which is dy dx, we can use implicit differentiation on both sides of this equation to find y prime. So the first step in implicit differentiation is differentiate both sides of this equation with respect to x. On this side of this equation, notice this function, sine here, is an outer function, and this y here is an inner function. So when we differentiate this composite of these two functions, we need to use what kind of rule? Yes, the chain rule. According to the chain rule, we're going to differentiate this outer function sine of y with respect to y, and that will give us cosine of y. And by the chain rule, we need to multiply the derivative of this inner function y with respect to x. So we multiply y prime, or you can put dy dx over here. Now we're done with the left side of this equation. On the right side of this equation, we're going to differentiate x with respect to x, which is going to be 1. Now the second step of implicit differentiation to find y prime is to solve for y prime. So y prime over here will be equal to 1 divided by cosine of y, which is equal to secant of y, because secant and cosine are reciprocal of each other. Now we want to express this in terms of x. The trick to do this is a y triangle over here. So what do we have over here? We have sine of y equal to x. Think about this y here as an angle in radian. So I draw a y triangle over here, label this angle y. Sine of y is equal to x. And we can write this x here as x over 1. We know sine is opposite over hypotenuse. So we can label this opposite side of this angle here as x, and label this hypotenuse over here as 1. Now by the Pythagorean theorem, this leg over here, this side of this right triangle, is equal to the square root of 1 squared minus x squared, which is the same as the square root of 1 minus x squared. Once you label the three sides of this y triangle, we can now express this secant of y in terms of x. Now looking at this y triangle, remember secant is hypotenuse over adjacent. So that will be 1 over square root of 1 minus x squared. The hypotenuse over here is 1, and the adjacent side of this angle here is square root of 1 minus x squared. So secant of y is 1 over square root of 1 minus x squared. Now we can write this result back over here. We found that y prime is equal to this. So now we have a formula. If y equal to inverse sine of x, then y prime will be equal to 1 over square root of 1 minus x squared. Now what about this inverse trig function, inverse tangent of x? We're trying to find the derivative of this function with respect to x. Now we know the derivative for tangent. We try to rewrite this equation in terms of tangent. So if y is equal to inverse tangent of x, then x is equal to tangent of y, because inverse tangent and tangent are inverse functions. So x is equal to tangent of y. Now we can use implicit differentiation to find y prime. The first step is to differentiate both sides with respect to x. You see on the left side over here, this is a composite of two functions. The outer function here is tangent. The inner function is y, which is a function of x. So to differentiate this with respect to x, we need to use what kind of rule? What rule do we need to use? Yes, the chain rule. According to the chain rule, we're going to differentiate this outer function, tangent of y, with respect to y. Now remember the trig I shared with you, the SST trig. The derivative of tangent is secant times secant, which is secant squared. So the derivative of tangent of y will be the square of secant of y. And the chain rule says that we have to multiply this by the derivative of this inner function with respect to x. So the derivative y with respect to x, you can put y prime or you can put dy dx over here. We're done with the left side of this equation. On the right side of this equation, the derivative x over here is just 1. Now we can solve for y prime. The second step of this implicit differentiation to find y prime is to solve for y prime. So y prime over here will be 1 divided by secant squared, 1 divided by the square of secant of y, which is the square of cosine of y, because cosine and secant are reciprocals. Now we will try to express this in terms of x. Then we use our trig again. We draw a right triangle. Now, what do we have over here? We have tangent of y equal to x. Think about this y over here as an angle in radian. So we label this angle here y. We have tangent of y here equal to x. Tangent is opposite over adjacent. So I'm going to write this x here as x over 1. And if we label this opposite side here as x, then the adjacent side here will be 1. Now by the Pythagorean theorem, this hypotenuse over here is going to be the square root of 1 squared plus x squared. Now we got the three sides of this y triangle. We can express this cosine of y by looking at this y triangle here. Cosine is adjacent over hypotenuse. So cosine of y here will be 1 over square root of 1 plus x squared. And now we're going to substitute this result back to this expression right here. We're going to square this 1 over square root of 1 plus x squared. Squaring the numerator, we got 1. Squaring the denominator, we got 1 plus x squared. So y prime over here will be 1 over 1 plus x squared. Now we got our formula. If y is equal to inverse tangent of x, or you can write arctangent of x, then y prime will be equal to 1 over 1 plus x squared. Now the inverse tangent function and the inverse sine function are the one that we encounter most frequently for the derivative. Those will be the two inverse trig function that you would like to remember the derivative to put the two formula together. So when y is equal to inverse sine of x, then y prime is 1 over square root of 1 minus x squared. For inverse tangent of x, the derivative is 1 over 1 plus x squared. This part of the derivative here remind me of 1 minus sine squared equal to cosine squared. This part of the derivative for inverse tangent of x remind me of the trig identity 1 plus tangent squared equal to secant squared. And if you find other trick to remember, please feel free to share that with us. And that's the end of 3.5.